Scientists are convinced JWST just found alien life on K2-18b. Has humanity's greatest question finally been answered in the atmosphere of a distant world? For decades, we've wondered if we're alone in the universe, and now the James Webb Space Telescope might have just delivered the answer we've been waiting for. In a discovery that has the scientific community buzzing, JWST has detected chemical signatures in the atmosphere of exoplanet K2-18b that are strikingly similar to those produced by living organisms here on Earth. The star of this cosmic show is a molecule called dimethyl sulfide, or DMS. On our home planet, this compound is almost exclusively produced by living organisms, specifically microscopic marine life like phytoplankton that float near the ocean surface. When JWST's sensitive instruments picked up spectral signatures consistent with DMS in K2-18b's atmosphere, scientists nearly fell out of their chairs. This wasn't any chemical detection. This was potentially the fingerprint of alien life. But that's not all. The telescope also identified dimethyl sulfide, DMDS, and a suite of carbon-containing molecules, including methane and carbon dioxide. Together, these compounds paint a picture that has astrobiologists reaching for their superlatives. The concentrations of these potential biosignatures aren't just similar to Earth's. They're thousands of times higher, suggesting biological activity on a scale that dwarfs anything in our oceans. What makes these findings so tantalizing is the specific nature of DMS. Unlike methane or oxygen, which can be produced through both biological and non-biological processes, DMS has fewer known abiotic pathways of production. On Earth, it's created when marine microorganisms break down a compound called DMSP as part of their metabolic processes. When scientists detect DMS in our atmosphere, they're essentially picking up the exhaled breath of ocean life. The technical achievement that made this discovery possible cannot be overstated. The JWST represents the pinnacle of human engineering and innovation, with capabilities that were stuff of science fiction just decades ago. Its near-infrared spectrograph and mid-infrared instrument allows it to analyze the light passing through K2-18b's atmosphere during transits across its host star. As this light filtered through the planet's atmospheric gases, certain wavelengths were absorbed, creating a chemical fingerprint that scientists could decode. When the data first came in, researchers reportedly double and triple checked their findings. The spectral lines indicating DMS were unmistakable, yet so extraordinary that caution was the watchword. In science, extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence, and the team wanted to be sure. This brings us to what scientists call statistical significance. The detections have reached what's known as a 3 sigma level, meaning there's only a 0.3% chance that these signals are simply random noise or coincidence. While impressive, the gold standard in physics and astronomy is 5 sigma, or a 1 in 3.5 million chance of error. That's the threshold the scientific community typically requires before popping the champagne and declaring a definitive discovery. What makes this evidence compelling, even to the skeptics and the scientific community, is the convergence of multiple lines of evidence. It's not just the presence of DMS, it's also the detection of other biologically relevant molecules, the location of K2-18b in its star's habitable zone where liquid water can exist, and the planet's classification as a potential Hycean world. These planets are characterized by having hydrogen-rich atmospheres above deep oceans, conditions that some scientists now believe could be ideal incubators for life. Even hardened skeptics are taking notice. Scientists who have built careers on cautious analysis of extraterrestrial claims are acknowledging that these findings represent the most compelling evidence yet for life beyond Earth. They're quick to note that confirmation requires additional observations, but the whispers in conference halls and virtual meetings have a new urgency. This could be it. The implications are profound. For all of human history, we've gazed at the stars and wondered if anyone or anything was looking back. The detection of these biosignatures doesn't yet confirm alien life with absolute certainty, but it pushes us closer to an answer than we've ever been before. It suggests that the universe might not be a lonely place after all, that the miracle of life may have occurred independently in at least two places in our cosmic neighborhood. What's particularly exciting is that K2-18b isn't an astronomical oddity. It's part of a class of planets that astronomers now believe are common throughout our galaxy. If life has emerged there, it may have done so on countless other worlds, painting the Milky Way with diverse biospheres waiting to be discovered. The implications of finding life on K2-18b stretch far beyond the mere detection of chemical signatures. They invite us to reimagine what alien biology might look like in environments widely different from Earth. K2-18b represents what scientists call a Hycean world, a planet with a hydrogen-rich atmosphere blanketing a water world, potentially with global oceans spanning its entire surface. This environment creates conditions unlike anything found on our home planet, yet potentially perfect for certain forms of life. If the biosignatures detected by JWST are indeed produced by living organisms, these life forms would be adapted to environments we can barely comprehend. With roughly 8.9 times Earth's mass and 2.6 times its radius, K2-18b experiences gravitational forces and pressure regimes that would crush most Earth organisms. Yet life, as we've discovered in Earth's most extreme environments, has a remarkable way of adapting. These alien organisms might resemble Earth's extremophiles, microbes that thrive in conditions once thought incompatible with life. Some extremophiles on Earth survive in hydrothermal vents where temperatures exceed 250 degrees Fahrenheit, while others flourish in highly acidic environments or withstand radiation doses that would kill a human thousands of times over. The potential life on K2-18b would likely put our extremophiles to shame, having evolved in a high-pressure, hydrogen-dominated environment that has no direct analog on Earth. The metabolic processes supporting life on K2-18b could be truly alien. On Earth, most life relies on photosynthesis or chemosynthesis, using sunlight or chemical energy to produce complex organic compounds. But in K2-18b's ocean depths, life might harness completely different energy sources. Some scientists speculate that organisms there could have evolved to utilize the abundant hydrogen in their atmosphere, combining it with dissolved carbon dioxide to produce energy and expelling DMS as a metabolic waste product. What's truly mind-bending is the scale at which these processes might be occurring. Remember, the detected levels of dimethyl sulfide are reportedly thousands of times higher than those found in Earth's oceans. This suggests biological activity on a massive scale, perhaps a planet-wide biosphere where life isn't confined to certain habitable niches, but flourishes across vast oceanic expanses. If you could dive beneath the clouds of K2-18b and explore its alien ocean, what do you think you'd find there? Single-celled organisms, complex ecosystems, or maybe even the alien equivalent of fish swimming through its depths? Let us know what you think in the comments below. And guys, just a moment before we continue, be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. The abundance of these biosignatures raises another tantalizing possibility. Could K2-18b support more complex multicellular life? While many scientists believe that the first confirmed extraterrestrial life will be microbial, K2-18b's apparently robust biosphere could potentially support more complex organisms. Evolution on Earth took billions of years to produce multicellular life, but with different environmental pressures and opportunities, evolution on K2-18b might have taken a different path. Imagine organisms that have evolved gas bladders to float at different ocean depths, creatures that harvest energy directly from the hydrogen-rich waters, or colonial organisms that form vast floating mats at the ocean-atmosphere interface. Without the constraints that shaped Earth life, like the need to resist gravity on land or protect against harmful UV radiation, evolution might have explored entirely different designs. The sheer volume of potential biological activity suggested by the JWST data indicates that if life exists on K2-18b, it isn't just hanging on in isolated pockets, it's thriving. This challenges our understanding of habitability. For decades, scientists focused on finding Earth 2.0, a rocky planet with a nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere orbiting a sun-like star at just the right distance. K2-18b shatters that mold, suggesting that life might flourish in environments we previously considered hostile. Hydrogen-rich atmospheres offer excellent protection from stellar radiation, while global oceans provide remarkable stability and temperature. These conditions could actually make planets like K2-18b more suitable for the emergence and persistence of life than Earth-like worlds. Some astrobiologists now suggest that Hycean worlds might be the most common abodes for life in the universe. If confirmed, the biological activity on K2-18b would represent a distinct genesis of life, a second data point that would transform astrobiology from a theoretical science to a comparative one. By studying the similarities and differences between Earth life and K2-18b life, scientists could begin to distinguish between the universal requirements for life and the peculiarities of Earth's evolutionary history. The possibility that evolution has played out twice within just 124 light years, a tiny distance on cosmic scales, suggests that life might be commonplace throughout our galaxy. If two nearby stars host life-bearing planets, then the Milky Way could be teeming with biospheres of bewildering diversity, each adapting to their unique planetary conditions in ways we've barely begun to imagine. The discovery of potential biosignatures on K2-18b represents what could be the most profound paradigm shift in human history. If confirmed, we would finally know with certainty that Earth is not the only cradle of life in the cosmos. This realization fundamentally transforms our understanding of life's place in the universe from a question of if to a question of how common. The statistical implications are staggering. For decades, scientists have used the Drake equation to estimate the number of civilizations that might exist in our galaxy. But one crucial variable, the fraction of suitable planets that actually develop life, have remained pure guesswork. Finding life on the very first exoplanet we've been able to study in sufficient atmospheric detail would suggest that biology emerges readily when conditions permit, potentially pushing this fraction close to 1.0. Consider the cosmic math. Astronomers estimate there are roughly 40 billion Earth-sized planets in habitable zones around sun-like stars and red dwarfs in the Milky Way alone. If K2-18b is indeed harboring life, and it's not an extraordinary fluke but rather an indication of life's prevalence, then billions of worlds in our galaxy alone could host biospheres. The universe, far from being a desolate wilderness dotted with rare oases of life, might instead be a fertile landscape where biology is the ruler rather than the exception. Verification of these findings remains the crucial next step. Scientists are planning additional observations with JWST's instruments to achieve the 5 sigma confidence level that would elevate these detections from compelling evidence to scientific confirmation. This would involve longer observation times and different spectroscopic techniques to eliminate potential alternative explanations for the chemical signatures. Beyond JWST, next-generation telescopes like the Habitable Worlds Observatory, currently in development, will enable even more detailed characterization of exoplanet atmospheres. These future observatories might be able to detect additional biosignatures and perhaps even identify specific metabolic processes occurring on worlds like K2-18b. The breakthrough also changes how we think about where to look for life. The focus shifts from just Earth-like planets to a broader category that includes Hycean worlds, potentially expanding the habitable real estate in our galaxy by orders of magnitude. Astronomers have already identified dozens of similar planets within observational reach of our current technology, each one now a promising target for follow-up studies. One of the most profound implications is philosophical. Humans have speculated about alien life for centuries, but always with the caveat that we might be alone in the cosmos. If life exists on K2-18b, the exceptional status of Earth life vanishes. We would be forced to reconceptualize ourselves not as the universe's singular biological experiment, but as participants in a grand cosmic phenomenon that has manifested itself repeatedly across the stars. This raises fascinating questions about the diversity of life. If biology can take hold in environments as different from Earth as K2-18b, the range of possible adaptations, metabolisms, and even biochemistries expands dramatically. Life might be built on different molecular foundations, harvest energy in ways we've never considered, or organize itself according to principles we've yet to discover. The road from microbial life to intelligent civilizations remains long and potentially fraught with evolutionary bottlenecks. Yet, if simple life is common, the odds improve that somewhere on some fraction of life-bearing worlds, intelligence has evolved. While K2-18b itself, with its crushing gravity and global ocean, seems an unlikely home for a technological civilization similar to our own, other worlds with different conditions might be more conducive to the development of intelligence and technology. If nothing else, this potential discovery humbles us. It suggests that the miracle of life is not a one-time cosmic accident, but a recurring phenomenon, a natural outcome of chemistry under the right conditions. Our specialness, if we can claim any, may lie not in our biological existence, but in what we choose to do with our awareness of our place in the living universe. As we await further confirmation of these tantalizing findings, we stand at what could be a pivotal moment in human history. The threshold of knowing, for the first time, that we are not alone. The seemingly simple detection of certain molecules in the atmosphere of a distant world may ultimately be remembered as the moment humanity's cosmic perspective fundamentally changed forever. If these findings hold up to further scrutiny, future generations might look back at this discovery as the moment we truly understood our place in a universe abundant with life. A revelation as significant as Copernicus showing that Earth is not the center of the solar system, or Darwin demonstrating our kinship with all terrestrial life. In this new perspective, we are neither alone nor central, but considered to be a grand biological tapestry that stretches across the stars. If you found this exploration of potential alien life fascinating, be sure to watch our other videos on the end screen. Stay insanely curious.